Hello. This is a video on arithmetic and geometric sequences. I'm going to be using this handout, and I will be putting the link to this nice handout down in the notes. A sequence is a list of numbers in a particular order, for example, 3, 6, 9, 12, and so on. We use A1 for the first term, A2 for the second term, and so on. I would like to have a little bit more formal definition of sequence that will help us make some connections in mathematics. Here is a good definition of a sequence. A sequence is a function whose domain is a set of natural numbers, or a subset of the natural numbers. We usually use the natural numbers, which are the set 1, 2, 3, and so on. So the input values are going to be 1, 2, 3. We usually use the symbol AN to represent a sequence where N is a natural number and AN is the value of the function on N. So let me write a couple of examples here. Let's take this simple sequence, 4, 8, 12, 16, and so on. A1 is 4, A2 is 8. So if we were going to write a formula for AN, we could write this as AN equals 4N. And we could calculate A1, A2, and so on from this. In function notation, we might write it this way, F of N equals 4N. Or oftentimes with function notation, we use x as our dummy variable. This is the same function. Typically, with function notation, we do allow decimal inputs, like maybe 1/2. F of 1/2 would be 4 times 1/2, which is 2. In the case of a sequence, we do not allow decimal or fractional inputs, but only the whole numbers. Let's return to our handout. First of all, we have the arithmetic sequence. We're going to have only two types of sequences today. An arithmetic sequence is a sequence where each term is found by adding a constant to the previous term. This constant is called the common difference, and we usually use the letter D. In this first example, the common difference is 3. The first term is also 3. That isn't always the case that the common difference and the first term are the same. If we take a look at number 2 here, it's asking for the common difference. What number is being added to 55 to get 49? And the same number is being added to 49 to get 43. The number that you add to 55 to get 49 is -6. Now we need to take a look at recursive and explicit formulas. In a recursive formula, each term is found by doing something to the term immediately in front of that term. So if we have 2, 4, 6, 8, and so on, each term is found by adding 2 to the term before it. And here is our formula. Here is the general formula for arithmetic sequences. AN is equal to A sub n minus 1 plus D. A sub n minus 1 is the term immediately in front of AN. For example, A7 is equal to A6 plus the common difference. If we subtract AN minus 1 to both sides, we get the following. AN minus A sub N minus 1 is equal to D. This is how we can calculate the common difference. Now let's move ahead in our handout. In our sequence, we have 2, 4, 6, 8. A4 is 8, A5 is 10. So if we want to use the recursive formula to find A6, it would look like this. A6 equals A5 plus 2, which is 10 plus 2. Therefore, A6 is 2. Our next question is, can we use this formula to find A100? The problem with that is that in order to find A100, I would need A99. This is one of the drawbacks of recursive formulas. So now we have the explicit formula to the rescue. And this formula right here in the colored box is a very important one, one that you want to learn in our number theory course. The explicit formula for an arithmetic sequence is that an is equal to a1 plus d times n minus 1. It only uses the first term, the number of the term that you're looking for, and the common difference. So I can jump all the way to a100 if I want to. Write an equation for the nth term in the sequence 8, 17, 26, 35. Well, what are the building blocks? The first building block is A1. That's easy. A1 is the first term, which is 8. Now we need the common difference. The common difference is 9. It's the number that you add on. So an is equal to a1, which is 8, plus the common difference, which is 9, times the quantity n minus 1. We always have n minus 1 in parentheses. It might be that you would simplify this with the distributive property, but sometimes we just leave it this way. Notice what happens when you plug in n equals 1. When you plug in n equals 1, n minus 1, 1 minus 1 becomes 0, and we do in fact get 8, so it does produce a sub 1. Try to do number 3 as a practice problem. Write an explicit equation for the nth term of the sequence 1.3, 3.8, 6.3. A50 is going to be 31 plus negative 7 times 50 minus 1. And 50 minus 1 is 49. And when we run this into a calculator, we get negative 312. A50 is equal to negative 312. The next question says, given this sequence defined by the function an plus 1 is equal to an plus 12, in other words, to get the next term, you add 12, together with the fact that A1 is 4, write an explicit formula. An is equal to the first term, which is 4, plus the common difference, which is 12, times n minus 1. Now we move on to the second type of sequence, which is a geometric sequence. And we have a nice situation because with the arithmetic sequence, we added a number to get the next number in the sequence. Here, a geometric sequence is a sequence where each term is found by multiplying the previous term by a constant called the common ratio, and we use the letter R. So our recursive formula is as follows. An is equal to an minus 1 times r. And if we divide, we get a formula for the common ratio. Dividing both sides by a sub n minus 1, we get a sub n divided by a sub n minus 1 is equal to r. So for question 5, our common ratio is going to be 20 divided by 8, which is 2.5. Or you might use the fraction form. Question 6, negative 1.5 divided by 1.25. And my common ratio here is negative 1.2. It is possible to have a common ratio that's negative. I'd like you to do number 7 as practice, and I think you'll find that the common ratio is a fraction less than 1 because our numbers are getting smaller. Question number 8. Write a recursive formula for the following sequence. Determine what we're multiplying by. An is equal to an minus 1, which is the previous term, times 2. Another way to state this is a sub n plus 1 is equal to a sub n times 2. Write a recursive formula for this sequence and then use it to find the fifth term. The common ratio here is 108 divided by 81, which is 4/3. So each time now, we're going to be multiplying by 4/3. So A2 will be A1 times 4/3, which is 108. A3 is A2 times 4/3. A4, we multiply by 4/3 again. A4 is going to be 192. A5, we multiply by 4/3 again, we get 256. So the fifth term is 256. But once again, we have the drawback of the recursive formula. So it would be nice to have an explicit formula. The explicit formula for a geometric sequence is that an is equal to a1 times r to the n minus 1 power. If you ponder this for a minute, you see some similarities. Instead of adding copies of a common difference, we're multiplying. And repeated multiplication is exponentiation. This is why we have the exponents. See if you can write an equation for the nth term of the following geometric sequence. Let's get our raw materials. The first term is our starting point, is 3. The common ratio is the ratio of any two terms. The common ratio here is 4. Then if we use our formula, an is equal to 3 times 4 to the n minus 1 power. I'd like you to do this question here for practice. And we'll do the next one together. Find the eighth term of the geometric sequence for which A1 is equal to negative 3 and the multiplier is negative 2. Our formula is that An is equal to my first term times my multiplier to the n minus 1 power. So therefore, A8 will be negative 3 times negative 2 to the 7th power. The terms in this sequence alternate from negative to positive, negative to positive. And when we multiply this out, we get 2. In the next question, we are given a recursive formula, and we are supposed to state the explicit formula. An is equal to the first term, which is 424, times our common ratio, which is 3/4, raised to the n minus 1 power. I'd like to point out that arithmetic sequences are actually linear functions. Remember, we said a sequence is actually a function whose inputs are the natural numbers. So, for example, if we take the example an equals 17 plus 3 times the quantity n minus 1, and we think of it in function notation from algebra, we can make it f of x equals 3x plus 14. 3 is our slope, and 14 is the y-intercept. Let's see what this would look like on a graph. Here we are at Desmos, and I have put in the function f of x equals 14 plus 3x, and we see here that the y-intercept is 0, 14. When we're thinking about sequences, we generally don't bother with this point because the first point of interest is the point where the input is 1. So let's go ahead and graph the sequence instead. And we see here we have a1 is 17, a2 is 20, A3 is 23, and so on. A geometric sequence is an exponential function. So using our sequence notation, we have an equals 5 times 2 to the n minus 1 power. If we put this in typical exponential function notation, we get f of x equals 2.5 times 2 to the x power. Let's look here using Desmos at the exponential function and the geometric sequence. F of x equals 2.5 times 2 to the x is this red line, and we can see that it crosses at 2.5 and at each time it doubles. If we put the sequence on there, I get these points. And I can take away the curve. And so we have 1, 5, 2, 10, 3, 20, 4, 40, doubling each time. I hope you found this video useful. Have a great day.